Ibraham Shakari is now addressing us at the AI Summit.
Organization of young men and young ladies, my very dear brothers and sisters of the great African continent, who are present. I join my earlier speaker in saying good morning to you all. I will complain like my sister. Didn't you want a good morning?
Good morning.
I'm sure we all recall our school days, in the, at least at the lower level. When the teacher comes in, they say, good morning, students. They say,
good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Ah, very good. Excellent and first class. You see, good morning, sir. Well, let me once again thank the organizers of this very summit of 2019 for inviting me to be part of this very, very historic and memorable summit. As we've just heard from the documentary presentation, I always believe that if you don't know where you are coming from, you will never appreciate where you are and you will never understand where you are going. So I am happy that you are reminded of where you are coming from. And this will keep us on track as to where we are today and where we are going. I wish to express my deep gratitude to God the Almighty, by whose grace I stand to address this distinguished gathering. My gratitude also goes to the leaders of this organization, whose invitation I have accepted with a profound sense of humility and duty. May I also express my joy for the opportunity offered to me to be associated with the activities of the umbrella body of Students and Young Men Association in the West African sub-region. I was asked to discuss with you in the official letter I got a topic titled Education as Panacea to Societal Development. But I had to change the title for obvious reasons. Even though I'm a mathematics teacher, I'm not a grammar man, and when you talk of panacea, education cannot be said to be panacea to development, because both of them are positive. You say A is panacea to B, because B is a problem, and A will be a solution to B. So I have decided to change it to educational development as a panacea for social problems. And I will be bringing experience from the Nigerian sector. By way of introduction, development is, in general, is what even government promises, especially those of us, the politicians in court. I've always argued I am not a politician, but a teacher in politics. It is what every community desires, and it is what every individual assumes. Naturally, every individual, it is an inbuilt aspiration to develop, to grow. All forms of development are to a very large extent measurable. But the question is whether or not development is in itself achievable. Development is highly subjective. Measurement of its achievement depends on who is doing the assessment and what specific issues are being measured. Assessing development through arbitrary indices with little or no consideration to peculiar issues and circumstances surrounding the society is not only unfair, but it does not yield any objective outcome. Certainly, if you are measuring development, you take into consideration some peculiarities. On the other hand, development with its summing subjectivity can be achievable with some conceptual clarifications. As one attempts to assess development in any given society, one must objectively redetermine the primary and other indices of development that can serve as reference points in that society. The United Nations Development Program, UNDP, its Human Development Indices and Indicators, 2018, statistical update, indicated that human development is a composite index measuring average achievement in three basic dimensions of human development: a long and healthy life, knowledge, and a decent standard of living. It is against this backdrop that UNDP reported that in 2018, in terms of Human Development Index, Nigeria ranked 156th position in 2016 and 157th position in 2017 among 189 countries, and ranked the 24th in Africa. I wonder where Liberia belongs. In terms of long and healthy life, life expectancy in Nigeria was rated at 53.9 years. The knowledge index is measured by the expected years of schooling, which was rated at 10 years. That means the number of years of schooling that a child of school entrance age can expect to receive if prevailing patterns of age-specific enrollment rates persist throughout the child's life. Mean years of schooling in Nigeria and was rated to 6.2 years. It is against this backdrop that the paper discusses many issues related to human, social, and economic development. Other issues discussed include education as a panacea for social problems, national and international efforts aimed at using education to bring about progress. Education is generally believed to be the greatest and the topmost agent of change in any society. The paper also presents some critical success factors that must be attended to for education to yield the desired outcome. Human, social, and economic forms of development, a comparison. Human and social factors are important components of the development process in any given society. Economic growth on its own cannot and has never guaranteed the reduction in poverty levels in the society. Economic development is just another factor of development and not the end goal. Development occurs more readily when the opportunities of the individual are maximized. And this happens only with the right type of education. These opportunities are brought to light in schools where the capabilities of the person are maximized. allowing the person to use his or her own skills. I'm happy the issue of skills and knowledge are also referred to by my sister Anna. Skills, knowledge, and experience and strength rise to raise himself or herself to a way of life and a standard of living which he or she values. Human and social development is based on the premise that the well-being of individuals and families cannot be fostered in isolation from the communities in which they live and the institutions that affect their lives. We always say the society and the human beings are interrelated because the human beings form society. And whatever happens in the society is a true reflection of the standards of the members of the community. Discussions on human development is therefore imperative when issues of social development arise. Social problems are societal and societal development. It is still debatable whether or not social problems retard and impede development and make it difficult or impossible. Or it is the so-called social development that comes along with its attendant problems, which lead to the escalation of social problems. The debate is untenable, but it is my opinion, as I will discuss later in this paper, that with the right type of education and adequate educational delivery services, social problems will be uprooted, no matter their source, and societal development will be ensured, no matter the impediments. With education, you can conquer and remove any impediments in societal development. Right education, of course. Functional education, sound and qualitative education. Social problems is normally attributed to a problem within a particular area or group of people. It is one of the general factors that affect and damage society. A social problem is any general behavior or condition that is prevalent among the majority in a particular society and has a negative effect on the society beyond what is seen as moral and just acceptable. Corruption, poverty, insecurity, and insurgency may be cited as typical examples of social problems in Nigeria. I'm sure my fellow Nigerian citizens here will agree with me that this is exactly one or some of the major problems we are currently experiencing. Issue of high level of corruption, poverty, insecurity, insurgency, and the like. The first and foremost root cause of many forms of social problems, according to Garba 2019, is the total lack of attention to education and its delivery. As I said, education is one of the major factor of change in any problem, in any society. Let us consider these two glaring facts as a judge. First, that 62% of people involved in drug abuse, armed robbery, and kidnapping are within the age range